I love history. I love South Dakota history. I started talking to people and trying to get some interest, see if there's some interest in restoring the tremendous amount of work that Roy and Edith had put in. There's some history here that could be saved that people just never know if it's not kept up. You know, that's what I'm trying to do.
Lynn Briggs has just replaced another Norman sign along an old Indian trail that zigzags across the prairie in west central South Dakota. This sign is one of 375 markers that Roy and Edith Norman originally installed in the 1970s to help preserve the trail's historic past.
The Deadwood Trail signs put up in 1975, and those were 52 signs that they had done, and so that was the first trail that he marked. And then I know in 1976 he put up 86 signs, and those are mostly Indian trails, mail routes, army trails, and then he marked the telegraph line.
Roy and Edith Norman became inspired to locate old trail routes after reading a book about local history. And after years of research, the Normans identified close to 400 places of interest and installed wooden signs.
He said, you know, when I was young, he said, I traveled these trails a lot and never thought about it until I started writing this book. And he said, then that come back to me that those old signs, or those old trails was there, and that he wanted to mark them and to preserve them for history.
The Normans' extensive research led to a number of boxes filled with legal pads full of notes and hand-drawn maps. Those materials were donated to the South Dakota State Historical Society, which was a welcome addition to their archives.
The maps that we have are down to the section, showing right where the trail went and the different trails. And then the notes we have here include the signs themselves, how they designed them, the cost at different times, how many signs they put up, and also where they're located.
Lynn uses those documents to help locate and replace the original Norman signs. While a number of the signs are conveniently located along highways and gravel roads, the rest are scattered across the prairie. Thanks to the efforts by landowners, these signs on private property are being found and replaced too.
There's a lot of landowners again that are helping out with it, just like when Grandpa started, you know, without them, he couldn't have done anything. So I don't know how my grandparents did it, and you know, 3 years they got those signs up, but we can't even hardly track them in 3 years, so it's pretty amazing what they did.
You could tell they loved history very much, especially in that part of the state, and they wanted to preserve it and make sure it lasted beyond their lifetime, which it has.
On this day, Lynn Briggs replaced two Norman signs. Signs ready to experience decades of South Dakota weather while preserving the integrity of these old trails for future generations.
For more information about the Norman trail signs, follow the links on our website.